Hello friends, now in this session we are going to discuss about one of the aspect of safety in engineering, that is related to the electrical safety, and the concept is earthing and bonding. So this is earthing and bonding of electrical system. Even from the image itself, it is clearly showing that what exactly the earthing is and what is bonding is. So from the image itself, you can understand the metallic connections or electric wire connections to the earth, that is called as earthing. Generally, this earthing is called as grounding in the US. And when these two metallic parts or electrical equipments are connected by the bonds or pipes or electrical wires, then it is called as bonding. So this connecting the metallic bodies of two machine is called as bonding, and this connection of this electrical equipment to the earth is called as earthing. So we will discuss exact details of this earthing and bonding in this session. So earthing is the connection between the metallic parts that is conductive, such as body frame, metallic enclosure, which is non-current carrying during normal operation of an electric appliance or installation, and earth. So this is the connection between the metallic part, that may be from the frame, metallic enclosure of that electrical appliances or the installation to the earth. So this earth means ground, and that is why in the US this earthing is also called as grounding. So why it is required? So actually, to avoid the shocks to the person, to avoid the electrocution to the person, this earthing or the grounding is required. Sometimes due to the electric current leakage or fault current discharges, that also cause an accident, and that is why earthing is required. So how it happens? If the live, that is phase, hot or line, wire touches to the metallic body frame of a machine or panel box enclosure, and someone comes in contact, that is by touching the machine frame or metallic enclosure, he will get a touch and then it got electric shock. So due to the high potential between the ground and the body frame, even electrocution may occur. So as earthing means to the earth, earth is ideally a zero resistance, means there is no current, and at electrical appliances, there is high current. So in this, between the electrical appliances and earth, there is a high potential difference. And if a person touches that metallic enclosure or that machine frame unknowingly, then he is in between the high potential and low potential, that causes a potential difference which may turns into the electric shock or the electrocution. So due to the fault current flowing through the victim body, that is through that person to the earth, that is why there is a chances of fatality also, because that is depends on the current or the voltage which is flowing through the electrical appliances, and if it is high voltage electrical appliances, then there is a chances of fatality. If it is low current or low voltage appliances, then there may be a severe injury or severe burn, etc. So that is one of the case, that to avoid the electric shock, we need earthing. Then for this reason, a bare or green with yellow strip wire is connected between the metallic body and earth electrodes. So these wires are connected to the electrical appliances to the earth. That is continuity conductor. So this way we can discharge this fault current to the ground, and hence earthing system protects the personnel from the hazardous electric shock. So this is one of the main reason to avoid this hazardous electric shock, we have to go for the earthing or grounding provision. Now there is another concept that is called as substation earthing. So we know the main station, substation, then distribution and transmission assemblies, etc. So this is the picture of this substation where this transformer, HV control, IHV control, this SCADA panel and different assemblies are there. So for all these electrical appliances, electronic appliances, controlling systems, we have to go for the earthing provision. So for this substation, what exactly the earthing is? The earthing system in a substation is to provide under and around the substation a surface that shall be at a uniform potential and near zero or absolute earth potential as possible. So ideally, the potential is near about zero. Or if it is not zero, then at least whatever the earth potential is there, up to that potential, we have to maintain that potential for all the surfaces. Now to maintain this potential that is equivalent to earth potential for all the surfaces is called as substation earthing. Then another concept is bonding. So bonding is the process of connecting and permanently joining two electrical conductors, machines, pipes, devices, and all the metallic parts in the power installations. So that is depending on the different electrical or electronic appliances which you are using in your industry. So we have to go for the bonding. That may be for the machines, for the pipes, for the devices, etc. So we have to connect these electrical or electronic parts, that is through the electrical conductors. So in this process, all the dead metallic parts, that is non-current carrying under normal conditions of the installations, are connected through a conductor, which equalize the potential difference between them. So one machinery or electrical appliance may be at high potential and another machinery or electrical appliance may be at low potential. So to equalize this potential, we have to connect these two appliances or two machineries. So this way a person is still protected from getting electric shock even if he touches two machines, because sometimes it happens unknowingly that two machines can be touched by a single person and you are in between the high potential and low potential electrical appliances. So you are in between the potential difference and then again you may have the electric shock or electrocution. And for that purpose, we have to connect these two electrical appliances or the machineries, and that is why it is called as bonding process. So we are going to bond these electrical appliances. So the bonding rod equalizes and makes sure that same electrical potential levels on the both surfaces. So this way there is no chance of current flow due to the lack of potential difference. Hence the system and personnel is well protected. So it is a basic law that high energy to low energy flow is always there. And if there is a potential equality, then there is no flow. So we can protect that person as by maintaining the equal potential with the help of this bonding. So for the reason mentioned above, a well bonding system connected to the earth is used to protect the persons, devices, equipment and other installations, as the earth bonding system make sure all the connected devices are the same level of voltage. Hence, no chance for discharge or the current flow. So we have already discussed that if there is no potential difference, the energy can't flow. That is, voltage or the current are equal at both the electrical appliances. bonding is necessary due to the following reason, that if there is no bonding, a person touching two different equipments at the same time will act as an equalizer and get electric shock due to the energy built up between the potential differences. And second reason is, if a live wire touches the metallic body of the machines and comes in contact with a person, may get hazardous, even fatal electric shock. So we know what exactly the bonding is. In this image also you can understand, this is the bonding, this is one electrical appliances of different voltage, this is another electrical appliances, that is motor. So motor is having different potential, welding machine is having different potential, and when we bonded these electrical appliances, then they are having the same electrical potential. So there is no potential difference, so we can avoid the electric shock to the person or damage from the machineries. It is recommended that both earthing and bonding between the external surface and metallic parts of the machines and ground for additional and perfect protections. So earthing is also required, bonding is also required, and that is depending on the conditions, because sometimes there are high voltage machineries are utilized, such as motors, transformers and generators. So sometimes it is a requirement, that is of earthing of these electrical appliances to the individual earthing provisions. So that is from two different separate locations using separate earth conductors and earth electrode plates. So we have to go for individual earthing provisions rather than the common earthing provisions, especially for the high voltage machineries. So earthing also provides a safe discharge path for the lightning strokes through gap, surge and lightning arrestors, hence make the system reliable with smooth operations. So from the earthing and bonding provisions, you can understand that we must go for the earthing and bonding provisions for each and every electrical equipments. So what is the importance of this earthing and bonding? So the primary purpose of earthing is to avoid the, minimize the danger of electrocution. Then there may be a chance of fire hazards if the earthing is not provided due to the current leakage, and then to ensure the potential of current carrying conductor which does not rise with the respect to the earth. So it's design insulations. So we have to avoid the fire hazards, we have to avoid the electrocution, we have to avoid the electric shocks, and we have to avoid the potential difference between the earth and electrical appliances. So that is the main criteria why we should go for the earthing. So some of the basic needs, to protect the human lives as well as to provide the safety to electrical devices, to keep voltage as constant in the healthy phases, to protect electrical systems and buildings from lightning, to serve as return conductor in electric traction systems and communication, to avoid the risk of fire in electrical installation systems. So in this diagram also, it is showing that when the electric shock is possible and when it is not possible. So you can go for this substation grounding. So it is at substation grounding. So basic shock situations here. So the persons are touching to these electrical appliances knowingly or unknowingly, and if there is no earthing provisions or the bonding provisions, then there is a chances of shock. If the person is going to touch between the two appliances, then again there is a chance of potential difference and there is a chance of shock. So we have to provide this earthing as well as bonding provisions as per our requirements. So there are different terminologies which are used in this electrical earthing, like earth, earth, solidly earth, earth electrode, earthing lead, earth continuity conductor, sub-main earthing conductor and earth resistance. So we will discuss in the picture as well as in the process what exactly these terminologies are. So there are basically three components in the earthing systems. First is earth continuity conductor, second is earthing lead, and third one is earth electrode. So from this picture you can understand the earth continuity conductor. So this wire which is connected to the metallic appliances or the electrical appliances and to the connecting point of that earth. So that is earth continuity conductor. Then earthing lead. So earthing lead is here. That is from the connecting point to the earth. So that wire is earthing lead. And here this connecting point is shown in this large view. So this is the connecting point. Then earth electrode, that is earth plate. So under the ground, this plate which is used, that is called as earth electrode. So this is earth electrode. Second is earthing lead, which is connected to the connecting point of this earth continuity conductor. So these are the three major components of this earthing system. So there are different types of electrical earthing. Basically, there are three types. The methods which is used for the electrical earthing. First one is plate earthing. So if you go for the plate, so if for the earthing purpose, you are going to use the plate. So that plate earthing system made up of copper with the dimension 60 centimeter into 60 centimeter into 3.18 mm or galvanized iron, that is GI, of dimension 60 cm into 6.35 mm is buried vertical in the earth, which should not be less than 3 meter from the ground level. So it is shown in this diagram. So please observe, this is the plate. So here are the dimensions, 60 centimeter into 60 centimeter into 3.18 mm. So this plate is having these dimensions. Normally it is of copper or GI plate, and around this plate the charcoal is inserted. So the dimensions for this charcoal are also mentioned, that is 15 centimeter and then by 90 centimeters. So this is 90 centimeter and this plate is of 60 centimeter. So around this plate charcoal is inserted and this plate is connected. Now here the depth is minimum 3 meter and the connectivity is from this point of this plate up to this earth level or the surface is 1.5 meter minimum and maximum 3 meter. So in this case also, where this cast iron hinged to CI frame is also there, and around that the concrete, the cement concrete is there, and here the funnel system is incorporated, and these funnel systems and these connectors are connected to this metal plate. So the detailed dimensions as well as this diagram is clearly showing in this diagram. So these are the copper plates or GI plates, which is shown in this diagram. Then different parts like bolts, nut, check nut and washers to be of copper for copper plate and GI for GI plates. So normally we have to use only a single material. So to avoid the potential difference, to avoid the corrosion, we have to use a single material. So this funnel covered with wire mesh assembly is shown in this diagram with all the dimensions like 300 mm by 300 mm for this cast iron, and other dimensions are also shown. So this is one of the method for earthing, that is called as plate earthing. Then another is pipe earthing. So instead of plate, we are using the pipe, right? So you can observe this in the diagram itself. So a galvanized steel and a perforated pipe of approved length and diameter is placed vertically in a wet soil. In this kind of systems, earthing, it is the most common systems of earthing. So this pipe system or pipe earthing system is a commonest method. The size of the pipe we use depends on the magnitude of the current and the type of soil. So characteristics of soil, soil resistivity, the moisture present in the soils are the different parameters are also important while designing this earthing method. The dimension of the pipe is usually 40 mm in diameter and 2.75 meter in length. So for ordinary soil or greater for dry and rocky soil. So these are the dimensions, that is 40 mm and 2.75 meter for the ordinary soil. The moisture of the soil will determine the length of the pipe. So we have already discussed that. The moisture present in the soil, the characteristics of the soils are deciding the length and the diameter of that pipe. So you can observe the pipe earthing in this diagram. So this is the pipe. So here it is mentioned the dimensions. Then it is 38 mm GI pipe, 150 mm. Then salt layer is there. And here charcoal layer is there. Salt layer as well as charcoal layer are inserted around the pipe. Then alternate layer of charcoal or coke and salt. So these are the different layers. So this is salt layer, this is charcoal layer, and likewise the alternate charcoal and salt layers are inserted. Then this is connected to this CI cover, again CI frame here, and in the previous plate earthing also the similar funnel system, CI covering, the dimensions, and then the cement concrete. So all these provisions are made and all the dimensions are shown in this diagram. Then the third method is rod earthing. So it is the same method as pipe earthing. The copper rod of 12.5 mm diameter or 16 mm diameter of galvanized steel or hollow section 25 mm of GI pipe of length about 2.5 meter are buried upright in the earth manually or with the help of pneumatic hammer. The length of embedded electrodes in the soil reduces the earth resistance to a desired volume. So you can observe this copper rod electrode earthing systems. So this is the surface level, that is earth level. This is the earth rod. These are the electrolytic roots. This is the earthing lead and this is earth bed. So this is steel driving cap, copper earth rod. This is dowel, which is connected to these copper earth rods. Then hardened steel tip. So to drill that earth surface, we have to use this steel tip also. And the dimensions are already mentioned, that 8.2 feet. So that is 4 feet plus this 4 feet and 0.2 feet. So this is third one, rod earthing. So these are the different methods which are used for the earthing. So there are different benefits of health assessment of earthing systems. So we have to check, we have to inspect these earthing systems on a frequently basis. So if you inspect or check the earthing systems on a regular basis, then various benefits are like ensure earthing systems are working correctly to protect the assets as well as humans. Then identification of installations that need remedial actions, cost effective and foolproof method for diagnosis and revamp, then compliance with all relevant safety standards and legislation, then shortcomings in designs, defective material, specification, size and quality, then bad or poor workmanship and safety to humans. So safety to humans, safety to the assets or the electrical appliances, motors, etc., and to comply the legal requirements. All these things are the benefits of this health assessment of earthing systems. So these are the different legal requirements. So we have already discussed CEA 2010 rule in detail in one of the video, that is Central Electricity Authority 2000 rule. So with reference to this rule, the descriptions are this one. So likewise, you can go through the different rules and the description given. So in this criteria, there are variety of lines like 250 volt line up to 250 volt. There is a different criteria. Then from 250 volt to 650 volt, there is different criteria. Then 650 plus, there is different criteria. Then for 33 kV, etc., are the different criteria. So for different criteria, different voltages, we have to follow the different resistances guidelines, different earthing guidelines, different bonding guidelines. So all these things are given in the CEA 2010 rule as well as in the Indian electricity rule and in some of the standards like IS 3043 or IS 7689, etc. Then other standards which are used for following these earthing and bonding systems like IEEE 802013, that is the guide for safety in AC substation grinding, then grounding, then IEEE 81, that is IEEE guide for measuring the earth resistivity, ground impedance and earth surface potential of a grounding systems. So this IEEE means Institute of Electrical and Electronic Engineers Association. So these IEEE guidelines are very useful for the electrical as well as electronic engineers. Then CBIP manual on AC system grounding, then IS standards, that is Indian standards, IEC 62305, that is specially for the protection against lightning protection. Then there is a British standard 7430, code of practice for protective earthing installations. Then IS 3043 is for the code of practice for the earthing. So these are the various codes and standards available for the earthing and grounding provisions. Then what exactly the resistance which is recommended for this earthing? That is one of the questions normally asked by the students as well as the industrial persons. So if you know the basic definition of the resistance, so we already learned that is Ohm's law, V equal to IR. So on the basis of V equal to IR, we can define the resistance as V upon I. So this earth resistance is nothing but voltage to the current ratio. So that is the basic requirement, or it is called as earthing resistance. But in number, what exactly in terms of ohms this earth resistance is suitable one? So for that purpose, it is not a specific number that is applicable for all, because on the basis of the soil characteristics, on the basis of moisture present in the soil, on the basis of voltage and current which is available or designed for these electrical appliances, on the basis of different parameters, we have to go for the different earthing resistances. So the recommendations are different one. So if you go for the NAC 250, then they recommend at least 25 ohms. That is the satisfactory resistance value for the grounding systems, right? So that is for the single earth bit, and it is a general requirement. But typically, it is a 5 ohm value fulfill the most of the applications, except some specific applications. So value of earthing system resistance are different for the different cores. Now with reference to the IEEE standard 142, with reference to 4.1.3 system ground, the recommended resistance is 1 ohm to 5 ohm. That is generally suitable for the industrial plant substations and buildings and large commercial installations. Then with reference to the National Electricity Code, that is NEC 2011, ISSP 30, Chapter 14 of India, with reference to 3.0.9, there is a recommendation of resistance of 5 ohm again. Then with reference to IS 3043, there is a recommendation of 1 ohm resistance. So this is applicable for the main earth grid connected with the transformer or the return path. So again, the application is different one. That is why resistance is also different one. And codes or the standard codes are also different. With reference to OISD 137 India, that is Oil Industries Safety Directorate. So this is mainly applicable for the oil industries. So for oil industry sector, we have to go for the 4 ohms for electrical systems and metallic structures, 7 ohms for storage tanks, and 1 ohm for main earth grid and bonding connections between the joints in pipelines and associated facilities. Then with reference to IS 2309, with reference to 12.3.1 resistance to earth for the lightning protection systems, there is a recommendation of earthing resistance as 10 ohm. So from these different applications, different conditions and different codes and standards, we can understand there is a range between 1 ohm to 10 ohm mainly, and sometimes 25 ohm. Ideally, the earth resistance should be 0. But in most of the cases where critical conditions are there, then most of the standards are recommended 1 ohm as a recommended earthing resistance. So this is all about the earthing and bonding. Thank you.